بسم الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله. إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره، ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح للأمة فكشف الله به الغمة. اللهم اجزه يا ربنا خير ما جازيت نبيًا عن أمته، ورسولًا عن دعوته ورسالته، وانفعنا يا ربنا بشفاعته. ثم أما بعد، إخوة الإيمان والإسلام، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل القائل في محكم كتابه: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد، ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد، واتقوا الله، واتقوا الله، إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة، أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. My brothers and sisters, our khutbah today is about fitnatul mal, the test of money, the test of money. The money, it is a blessing from the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we cannot count. As Allah mentioned in the Holy Quran, المال والبنون زينة الحياة الدنيا. The wealth and the children. It is the enjoyment of this life. Being rich, my brothers and sisters, there's nothing wrong with this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had created us. And He had the decision subhanahu wa ta'ala for some people to be poor. And some people to be rich. For the poor people, they have to be patient. And this is their test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for the rich people, to spend the money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To spend the money by the way that he wants, not by the way that he wants, not by the way that we want. So it's also, it is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, may Allah be pleased with him. He said, Allahumma inna la nastati'u illa an nafraha bima zayyantahu lana. Allahumma inna la nastati'u illa an nafraha bima zayyantahu lana. Allahumma inni as'aluka an unfiqahu fi haqqi. Sayyidina Umar al-Khattab, may Allah pleased with him, said, O Allah, we cannot enjoy anything except that you had blessed us with, which is talking about the wealth. And he said, O Allah, let us spend the wealth that you blessed us with by the way that you want, O Allah. My brothers and sisters, as I just mentioned, being wealthy, there is nothing wrong with this. But being wealthy and not to spend the money by the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created it for, this is the mistake. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had mentioned in the Quran, إِنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنًا. The wealth, the money, and the children, it is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah had said in the end of the ayah, وَاللَّهُ عِنْدَهُ أَجْرٌ عَظِيمٌ. And Allah had a special reward for whoever spent the money for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, the top test in this life for Ummah and Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the money, al-mal. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن لكل أمة فتنة وإن فتنة أمتي المال. النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم said, for every community a فتنة and فتنة, which is a test, and فتنة أمة النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم is المال, the money. The top test for Ummah and Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is al-mal, the money. My brothers and sisters, how many times that you ever heard or seen some people, they were poor and they were happy. And they become rich and they become more sad. And they are becoming having miserable life. Why? Receiving wealth from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that great blessing, it should make us happy. It's a ni'mah. Allah had mentioned in the Quran, al-mal wal-balun zina. Being wealthy and having children, this is the enjoyment of this life. So how come when some people, when they were poor, they were happy, and when they become rich, their life changed to the bad way? You know what the difference is? The difference is, when we were poor, we used to spend more time for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We used to spend more time pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 5 times prayer in the masjid. 5 times in the masjid. They were reciting the Quran every single day. They never miss even a day. They were making azkar, remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were helping others. They were making a lot of worship. And when they received the money, they become busy for it. And they become more hungry for money. They are starting to research for money, to collect money from all over, to make it bigger and bigger and bigger. They don't care if it is from halal way or if it is from haram way. All they care about is to collect as much as they can. Why? By receiving al-mal, you should be more happy. You should have more time to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more. Why? Because I become rich, I had opened my own business. I do have my own workers. I do have my own money. So I do have excuse not to pray on time. Not to pray with the jama'ah. Not to attain hilaq al-ilm. The Islamic studies lectures are over. Why? I should have more fear and more love for Allah and more time of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that I do have whatever I need. I could spend money for my own, my family, without difficulty now. When I was poor person, I used to work more to be able to take care of my family. But still, I used to have time to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to please Him. I used to pray on time. I used to be more close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking Allah, oh Allah, make my life easy. Oh Allah, give me this. Oh Allah, give me that. Oh Allah, you know my situation. You know my children. They need money and I don't have it. Oh Allah, please, please give me. Allah give you subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you become rich, your connection between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes loose, becomes like weak. Why? Why? This is the difference. And I had mentioned there is nothing wrong being a rich person. Nothing wrong at all. Al-yadu al-ulya khayr min al-yad al-sufla. Giving or helping others, if you have the money and you help others, is better than don't have money and you can't help others. Of course, there is no doubt about it. But the problem or the issue is وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If we count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above us, we can't count. And from the best blessings, from the top blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this life for us, having money, being wealthy, and having children according to the ayah of the Quran, المال والبنون زينة الحياة. So the person, he could made his life by his hand difficult or full of worship. So the difference is, the problem is where? Is in us. That we do have a blessing and we don't know what can we do with it. Of course, according to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَكْبُرُ الْعَبْدِ وَيَكْبُرُ مَعَهُ اثْنَانِ. When the son of Adam become older, much old, he will have more love for two items, for two things. يَكْبُرُ مَعَهُ اثْنَانِ. حُبُّ الْمَالِ وَطُولُ الْعُمُرِ. Two things. Loving to have more wealth and loving to have longer life. Yes. But subhanAllah al-Azim, قَلِيلٌ مِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَنْتَبِهُونَ لِهَذِهِ. Not much people, they take care of that point, or they focus in that point that I do have the money, I should help others more. I do have the money, I should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more. I do have money, I should have more time for Allah. I should have more connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-mal khayr. Having money is khair, is good. There's nothing wrong with this. But still, it is test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah had mentioned the Quran, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً. Test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could be good or bad. Which is, being wealthy is good. But it's a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Being poor is not good, but still it's a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تزول قدم عبد يوم القيامة حتى يسأل. In the day of judgment, there is responsibilities Allah will ask us about it in the day of judgment. From the major responsibilities that Allah will ask us about it in the day of judgment, number one, عن عمره فيما أثناه, about his age. About the time that Allah has given to us. How did we spend our life? Allah had mentioned in the Quran, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ. We should spend our life for Allah, pleasing Allah, because He created us for that point. Not for collecting money from all over, halal way, haram way, it doesn't matter. By being rich and having more money and more money and more money, this is the important point, this is the big problem. عَنْ عُمْرِهِ فِي مَا أَفْنَى. And subhanAllah, there is another hadith, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ طَالَ عُمْرُ وَحَسُنَ عَمَلُ. The best among you that Allah had blessed him with longer life, but with a condition, with good action. You can't compare between someone lived in this life 50 years. 50 years of fortune. Good. And someone lived 90 or 100 years. 100 years of fortune, almost double. Double time of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many people they lived in this life for 70 or 80 years? And how many years they spent for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They were focusing, worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, subhanAllah Azim. You can't compare between someone, he born a Muslim, a believer, and he spent all his life for Allah. Always since he was like a little child, until he become 90 years old, he is always in the masjid. Always you see him in the masjid. Until you could tell, when his name is mentioned anywhere, everyone will know this person is a good person, he's always in the masjid. And we can't judge people according to what they ever have in their own hearts. But we could judge people according to whatever we can see. Inside their hearts is up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We can't judge people. But علامة الظاهر دلالة على علامة الباطن. The signs that you could see in front of your eyes, it is from the signs of the person that he had in his own heart. If you see someone who's in the masjid, you can't say anything bad about him. You can't say, oh, he's just faking it. No, this is bad. Because you know what he had in his own heart. And actually whoever had the signs outside good, truly he is honest person. Usually. He is honest person. Because he not show off in front of you today and tomorrow and after tomorrow. It could be for a few days, could be for a month, but not for the whole entire life. For someone always in the masjid, that means he is a good person. So you can't compare between someone lived 50 years of fortune and 100 years of fortune. Or between someone since he born until he passed away, he's always practicing the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And between someone, he born a Muslim and he wasn't practicing until the age of 60. And then he said, oh, I am almost close to die. Let me go to the masjid. Repeat back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and start to practice the religion. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive subhanahu wa ta'ala, but still, are going to be the same level in the heaven even? Allahu a'lam. لا تزول قدم عبد مؤمن قدم عبد حتى يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن عمره فيما أفناه. Number two, عن علمه فيما فعل. About his knowledge. How did he use it for? Some people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, list them with knowledge also. But they spend the knowledge not for pleasing Allah, not for helping humanity, no, to destroy the humanity. So they receive the knowledge to destroy the humanity. وَعَنْ مَالِهِ مِنْ أَيْنَ اكْتَسَبَهُ وَفِيمَ أَنْفَقَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him about his wealth. From where that he collected? From where did he receive it? وَفِيمَ أَنْفَقَ. And where did he spend it? وَعَنْ جِسْمِهِ فِيمَ أَبْلَى. Subhanallah al-Azim. Last point. عَنْ جِسْمِهِ فِيمَ أَبْلَى. Also according to the body. That some people, they want to go and have some fun. When they go having some fun, they might climb the mountain and jump from the mountain into the water. Or driving a bike on top of the mountain is a fun, a competition. They could die in a second. Putting yourself in danger is not permissible. Is not permissible. Because we did not own our own bodies. This is Allah's creation, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't own it. So, putting yourself in danger is not permissible. Subhanallah al-Azim. Al-Fuqara yadkhulun al-Jannah qabl al-Aghniya. Al-Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala qumtu ala bab al-Jannah fakana aabata man dakhalaha al-Masakeen wa ashabu al-Jaddi mah. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah had showed him a part from the day of judgment, from knowledge of the future. And he said, I was facing the entrance or the gate of the heaven, and I saw the poor people, they are in the heaven. He said, the majority of people in the heaven, they are the poor. And the rich people, they are waiting to enter the heaven. What does that mean? Could be both of them, they are good. The poor person, the poor people, they are in the heaven because they are good, they were patient. And the rich people also, they are good. But they cannot enter at the same time with the poor people. They have to wait. They have to wait for that. Subhanallah al-Azim. According to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَالَ يَدْخُلُ فقراء المسلمين الجنة قبل أغنيائهم بنصف يوم. The poor people will enter the heaven before the rich people. Just the rich people, they will wait for like half day. And you know what is the half day? وهو خمس مئة عام. The half day, it is 500 years. نصف يوم وهو خمس مئة عام. Which is 500 years. Subhanallah al-Azim. Why? Subhanallah al-Azim. As I mentioned in the hadith, that everyone will be asked about his responsibility. Everyone will have a test. Subhanallah al-Azim, being poor is a little test, actually, than being rich. Being rich is a bigger test. Because I do have a lot of things Allah will ask me about in the day of judgment. But the poor person was just trying his best to take care of his family, and he's not rich. The day of judgment, Allah is going to ask him about how much money that you could live to. And of course, he will be asked, of course. But there's not much money to be asked for. Subhanallah. So, as I mentioned, my brothers and sisters, being rich, there is nothing wrong with this. But subhanAllah, I will conclude the khutbah with the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. ذات قال صلى الله عليه وسلم للفقر أخشى عليكم ولكني أخشى أن تفتح عليكم الدنيا فتنافسوها كما تنافسوها فتهلككم كما أهلكتهم. نبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم he was not worried for his ummah to be poor people, but actually he was worried for the opposite way, for us to be rich and then we will run after the dunya, after it, and then it will destroy us as it destroyed people before us, which is you could see right now. Someone had 100,000 and he is not looking whatever he had in his hand. He is looking for his brother, he had 1,000,000. Or his friend, he had 2,000,000,000. So he cannot see the 100,000 that he had in his hand. He is looking for the 1,000,000 or the 2 in the other hands of people. And subhanAllah, this is your money that Allah had decided for you. You will never have any more than what Allah had decided for you to have. So why I have to live the same lifestyle like his? He had 1,000,000 and I do have 100. If I want to be living like his life, I have to have a credit card. And I have to have interest. And I have to spend money right and left, which is I can't own it. Which is I can't afford it to pay it later. And this is the problem. So having money, 100,000, you could live with it. You could make your own life with whatever you have. Whatever you have, you could make, you could build your own life. سبحان الله العظيم قد أفلح من أسلم ورزق كفافا وقنعه الله بما آتاه. If you have whatever you need for today, that means you have al-kafaf. You have whatever you need for today, don't be worried for tomorrow, because Allah will never forget you tomorrow, because He did not forget you today. He did not forget you today. If you have the money, the food and drink, and the place you stay for today, and you are healthy, that means you have everything. You are not missing anything in the dunya. My brothers and sisters, remember Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best mankind walking in the earth, and Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, and Sayyidina Umar al-Khattab, may Allah be pleased with them. Sometimes you don't have like hot meal for a month, or 2 and 3 months. Can you imagine that? The Messenger of Allah did not have a hot meal for a long time like this. Yes. Not even this. One day, suddenly he left his house because there is no food at all in his house. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not even a piece of date. Not even a piece of dry bread. Nothing. And he left his home because he could feel the pain in his stomach because he is hungry. Do you ever feel the pain of your stomach of being hungry one day? Even when we are fasting, we need it. We need to be fasting every day to burn some more calories. This is the truth. When he left, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he met Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and Sayyidina Umar. And he asked him, why you are walking at this time? He said, we are hungry. We are under pain and our stomachs don't have food. Radiallahu anhu wa ta'ala. So we are not better than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or the companions. So, قَلِ أَفْلِحَ مَنْ أَسْلَمْ وَرُزِقَ كَفَاءً وَقَنَّعَهُ اللَّهُ بِمَا آتَاهُ. We must be happy with whatever Allah had blessed us with. And we shouldn't look unless except whatever we have in our hands, not what people have in their hands. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم أنت ربنا لا إله إلا أنت، لا إله إلا أنت، خلقتنا ونحن عبادك، ونحن على عهدك ووعدك ما استطعنا. نعوذ بك من شر ما صنعنا، نبوء لك بنعمتك علينا ونبوء لك بذنوبنا، فاغفر لنا فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك، اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك، اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك، واغننا بفضلك عن من سواك. اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين، وعجل بالنصر يا رحمن، وردنا جميعا إلى دينك مردا جميلا يا رب العالمين. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على النبي محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وأقم الصلاة.